See, let's look at it this way. A nation, when we say a nation, all nations on the planet are not in the same state of development, evolution, and social and other realities are not in the same state. Looking at India as a nation, we are trying to make this a nation. Still there is no real nation, because still a whole lot of people are identified with their caste, creed, you know, many, many things, with their community, many, many things. Because we are yet to make a nation out of it. We should have done it early on after 1947, but we did not do that work properly. As you said, discrimination is there based on your caste. That means we've not made a nation yet. You are separate nation, I am separate nation, isn't it? Just because of your birth. So if you want to make this a nation, there are certain tools, certain symbols, certain acts, and anthem is one of them, that we are trying to make a nation out of this. And we are a nation where 500 million people have not eaten properly. Largest number of malnourished people on the planet, unfortunately, in our country. Nearly 60% of rural population in India, their skeletal system has not grown to full size, they are all like this, compressed, dissipated life, underdeveloped life we are generating. But we have debates about whether we should stand up or sit down when the anthem happens, all right? Simply because we've lost our humanity. I'll come to this. And we have issues with our sovereignty. Somebody is always trying to gobble part of what you call as India. That itself is not settled. We don't know where our borders are, yes? And you and me are sitting here today comfortably talking about many things simply because there are men who are standing there who are willing to die for this nation. You don't like it, it's fine. There are men and women who are willing to die for this nation. Every day they're dying. You may be seeing it as statistic, but unfortunately they have wives, they have children, they have families. A man who stands there willing to stake his life, willing to make his wife into a widow, willing to make his children into orphans, at least please tell him, we don't care a damn for this nation, you also come back, what are you guarding against? Why should a man stand there guarding this nation when we are not willing to stand up for a simple symbol of the nationhood? It is 52 seconds, it's a shame. Now, the kind of arguments people are creating is, what if somebody is handicapped? Arre, don't we have that much sense, if somebody is handicapped, we will not ask him to stand up? What nonsense is this? He can sit like this, he can sit like this, showing some expression for the nation. Nation has to evolve. If this nation in the next 25 years comes to a place where all citizens in this country are well nourished, we can bring down our nationalism and patriotism by 25%. If in another 15, 20 years or 25 years, if everybody is well employed, well to do, nation is bursting with prosperity, then you can bring it down to 50%. Someday if you come to such an egalitarian situation where there is no caste, no creed, no discrimination, gender, caste, creed, doesn't matter, we are all just boom. If you come to that stage, we can talk about dissolving the nation and making nation into a global possibility. But without understanding the realities, when your sovereignty is not fixed, when you don't know where the hell your border is of this nation, and half the people have not eaten properly, you are talking about in one hand popcorn, one hand Coca-Cola, and you can't stand up. No, this is not okay. This is not okay. This is not a question of nationalism, this is a question of your humanity.
So, Sadhguru, if I could just follow up on that answer you made. So, As I understand, you said that there are individuals like soldiers who show their allegiance to the nation by fighting for the borders, fighting in the borders. We are not loyal because we don't stand
Nobody
up
Nobody talked about loyalty, please.
We
need to understand this. There is… nation is not a God-given entity. It is an agreement among us what a nation is. Yes? Nation is not some God-given thing. It's we who made the nation. There is an agreement what we will respect, what we will not respect, what we value and what we do not value in this country. So this is an agreement that we have made. So this is not a question of your loyalty. Maybe you're doing some great work, but you don't want to stand up. But I'm telling you, this is not about you who is well-to-do. This is about those people who are still not fed properly. This is about those people who are dying on the borders. This is about those people who are being rubbed down to the ground on a daily basis.
So, Sadhguru, I completely understand.
How will sitting help? Please tell me first. No. How does sitting help? If one person stands up and speaks, it'll be nice. If you can stand up for this at least.
So could I complete the logical flow on the question I ask him, and then we'll put it to somebody there? Is that fine? Or like, do you want to ask right now itself?
Fine. Please take the microphone and speak, it's fine.
Fine, so I mean, the reasoning which I understood is that there are individuals who are sacrificing for the nation.
No, there is a condition.
There are individuals who subscribe to the idea of a nation, and the implication is that individuals who do not stand up for the national anthem do not subscribe to the idea of the nation.
No, not true. I am not saying that. This is a very simplistic logic. I am not saying that. I am saying nation is at a certain status of evolution. Do you understand? In this nation, we need an emotion to move this nation to a better status. For this emotion, everybody needs to participate. It's like saying, tomorrow you want to build a family. You go and tell your wife, see, I'm very agnostic, I will give you what you want, but I will not invest my emotion into this family. You think you will have a family? You think you will have one? So, standing up for the national anthem and a few other symbols of that is just that you are creating an emotion, because nation is only in the minds and hearts of people. It doesn't exist anywhere else. There is no nation in the world. Nation exists only in our minds and our hearts. If it doesn't exist in your heart, how will it exist? It will